We begin this half hour with new calls for better pay in the classroom.
Primary school teachers are among the lowest paid in the country. When adjusted for the cost of living, the salaries average around $42,000 a year.
I think we need to find solutions that are navigable for both the legislators and for us as teachers, and especially for the students and families and businesses of Arizona.
Take a look at just how many people are here downtown in front of the state building in Tucson. These teachers and their supporters say they are not going anywhere, and they want the governor and lawmakers in Phoenix to know they are not backing down.
Right now, Arizona teachers coming out in force, protesting at our state capitol.
Wearing red for Ed, the Arizona educators are taking a stand calling for higher pay.
It's a couple of thousand teachers are here behind me holding a rally as we speak. And in fact, they've just started to outline what they call their demands for Governor Doug Ducey and the legislature.
I'm hoping this video will be able to reach a couple of different people, people that don't know me at all. For those who don't know me, my name is Isaac Joel. I'm the owner and creator over at Opus Vita Studio. I had posted something on Facebook last week. I'm connected to a couple of teachers and educators, and I told them to comment or message me when the next walk-in was for Red for Ed. If you don't know what Red for Ed is, if you don't know what's going on, this video will inform you. The following footage that you're going to see is what took place. I was listening to the radio a couple days ago, and this woman was being interviewed, and she was talking about how her and her husband are educators and that there's not enough funding, to whereas they are paying themselves for equipment and supplies that the students need out of their own pocket. Right. That the schools aren't even providing, you know, exactly what it is they need through funding. And I mean, just imagine that, dude. Imagine being a parent. Imagine having three kids, a house, bills, a not so well paid job, and you're also paying at your job.
Yeah, you gotta take care of other people's kids also.
Exactly.
It's a lot of pressure and stress. The sky, I'll carry you home to the mountain near. And soon, my friend, you'll see them again. Won't you left behind the ones you left behind, and I'll sing for you all the way home.
Yeah, who's that?
Probably good. It's Natalie Schuler.
Here?
The music teacher,
here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll give her, because she's like the one leading it here.
Okay.
So that would be good.
For us, so we're gonna send it to you. But he wanted to see if you wanted to do like a little reporting video.
Do it. Yes, sure. Mackenzie's great. Yes.
We are part of this movement called Red for Ed, and in this movement, we are fighting what most people are focused on is the higher pay. They're fighting for raises for teachers, and everyone seems to be focused on that. But what the higher pay is going to do is bring in more people, and we're not just fighting for that 20% raise. We're also fighting for the rest of the education support staff, the aides, the cafeteria workers, the nurses, our parapros, everyone that is on campus, because everyone
not
is
not just teachers.
Not just teachers.
Okay.
And we are vastly underpaid as a whole, anybody that works on campus is pretty underpaid as far as the rest of the nation goes, especially.
Why not talk to the teachers?
I am talking to teachers.
Talking to the Red for Ed people, their teachers.
I'm supporting the teachers. I'm staying out of the political theater. Okay, so we're working on the policy.
You see them as just political theater.
I said I'm supporting the teachers. I think you know the people that founded Red for Ed, when they kicked it off, they announced an endorsement of my opponent in the governor's race. I think that's political activity.
A lot of that. He was calling it like a political circus, and that we were basically just the puppets to everybody else. And something that is interesting to me.
How insulting is that to a teacher?
It's frustrating because he keeps throwing out these numbers that are pretty inaccurate as well. He's saying that the average teacher makes $47,000. I make $35,000. I bring home about $1,600 a month, and I don't have any dependents on my health insurance. Luckily, if I did, that would be another $500 less that I bring home. That's what teachers are looking at. And there are teachers in the district that have been teaching for 20 years and have master's degrees and only make $40,000. So I don't know where his numbers are coming from, and he's just trying to basically find a scapegoat to not address the problem. And I feel like automatically jumping onto that political circus and saying that we're just the puppets of all these political activists is just his scapegoat at this moment, because he's starting to realize that we're not going to give up, and we're here, and we're going to fight the fight. And if you actually watched those interviews with him, he looks pretty flustered and looks like he's getting a little irritated, because he knows we're not going away. We're a super lucky district. Yeah. We have the support of our principal, our admin, our superintendent, our board. They're one of the first that jumped on board with supporting us as far as all that goes. Other districts have not been so lucky. There are still districts that are fighting to get their supers on board, to get their district board onto the bandwagon too. And it's kind of hard to convince people that are in charge of that many schools. We're a much smaller district too. We only have 12 schools, and other districts have 40, 30, 60 schools. So I think it's harder for them to get everybody on board at once.
I have more of a comment than a question.
Okay.
So, like, I understand, because I graduated about 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
But teachers have been a huge influence on me throughout my life. Of course, there's, you know, teachers here and there that don't really help out the students, that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. But for the most part in my life, I've had nothing but supportive teachers. Ms. Valenzuela here was my sixth grade elementary school teacher.
And here you are still.
Ms. Jones was my third grade reading teacher, and she even helped me after I left her class and went on to other grade levels.
Yeah.
I've had high school teachers that helped me supported me, because ever since I was 7 years old, what I'm doing right now is what I wanted to be doing then, and they've shown me nothing but support throughout all the years. And
that's so nice.
I had a trouble home and everything like that. I always felt like I never had my family support, so I always got it from my teachers, and I always do give my credit to, you know, I'm 19 years old right now. I'm getting ready to open up my studio business right now. I already have a couple of people employed with me, and I wouldn't have done anything that I'm doing now, if it wasn't for the support of my teachers.
Yeah.
So that's where I'm coming from this, is that's where people don't realize that what it is you guys do is, of course, education and everything like that, but you guys are huge influencers on students. Like that cliche saying, you guys are shaping the minds of the future.
Yeah.
That's so cliche, but like
it's kind of true.
It's 100% true. It's 100% true.
Yeah.
Did you have anything to say off of that? You know?
One, it makes me super happy to hear you say that, to know that teachers from such a young age are still in contact, you're in contact with them, and that they've made such an impact on your life. That makes me really happy. But you're right, and so many people don't think about that. I read one comment on Facebook. I shouldn't be reading comments on Facebook, but sometimes it just fuels my fire a little more.
Yeah.
Someone said that someday your job is just going to be replaced by an app. And I'm like, that you can possibly teach information through an app, but there's so much more to being a teacher, which you know. Yeah. And we need to make other people realize that you have to make connections and relationships with students and help them through things. You're not just teaching them. Mm-hmm. You are playing mom or dad or grandma or aunt or uncle or big brother or big sister. You're playing counselor and nurse, and you have so many hats as a teacher that goes beyond just teaching an education or giving an education to these students. Mm-hmm. You are that caring person, because like you said, a lot of people don't have that family support at home. Mm-hmm. And they get that here. A lot of students only have that support and their family is at school. Mm-hmm. So I just think that more people need to realize that, and more people need to think back to when they were a child and think back to how their teachers impacted their lives, because obviously you have thought about that and you realize that, but there's so many people that have either forgotten or just hadn't taken the time to think about what an impact their teachers actually made on them.
Again, the best way that we ourselves, people who aren't educators and work within schools, the best way that we can show our support for these employees is, you know, the little things, you know, like they said, wearing red or tying the red ribbons or painting your car red for Ed. These little things to help show support us as the community to these people. I mean, it's pretty common sense. You know, do we have to explain how much they're struggling? I think we can, as human beings, we can understand and comprehend and take a wild guess as to what it is they're going through. So let's show our support for our community. Thank you for watching, everybody. That's the end. All right. Let's go home. Ugh. They gave me a free box of batteries. That was pretty nice.